What's going on, guys? Blake Hawthorne, it's His Turf. I found out that you guys like money. So what do you think about a free way to be able to market and make more of it? Welcome, guys, to Lawn Care Tips and Tricks. In tonight's video, we'll be looking at a free way that you can market your company and make more money. But before we jump into that, we want to recap to last week's video. That was how to grow you from 3,000 to 9,000 in lawn care. What we did is we did a giveaway on one of our It's His Turf hoodies, and we're going to be announcing the winner at the end of this video, along with something else. So be sure and watch to the end. But let's go ahead and let's jump into how you can start growing and expanding your company and free ways of marketing. But before we really jump into some nitty gritty marketing, we have to kind of rewind today and start from the basics. What we need is for you guys to even have a presence, to start to even get recognized. And so by doing that, we're gonna cover some of the basics and jump into some free ways that you can market. So as I've mentioned before, it takes a customer 8 to 10 times of seeing your company or seeing one of your ads before they actually pull the trigger and go with you for the services. And so with knowing that, what we have to do is we have to figure out a way to get you noticed by your customers. And I'm gonna go back 10 years ago and how we started building this for our company here at It's His Turf. One of the first things that we started doing was with each and every customer that we landed is we were friending them with Facebook, we were inviting them to like our business page, and we were constantly posting pictures of finished work. This is something that I want to encourage you to start to do, is that you need to be focusing and targeting those customers. And what you'll see is that then those customers and your mutual friends will start to pop up in the friends list. Add those people to your friends list as well, because as you are posting pictures of the work that needs to be done, they're going to figure out, well, hey, so-and-so uses them, and that's why they're popping up on my newsfeed, and then they will be thinking about you for the service. It's a great way to be able to land them as your customer. Also, another way is once you have a Google listing, is asking for your new customers to go on and to leave you a review. When they leave you a review, this is gonna help you in building some SEO for your company. This is something that I didn't do very well at all early on, but I realize how important it is now. So I wanna help you by telling you about it so that you'll do it for your company and it'll help you in growing faster. So guys, don't get me wrong. There's things like door hangers and flyers and you know, fancy door hangers that you can use, but it's all irrelevant. There's also things that you can do that are gonna be yard signs. That side's dirty, but this side's not. And so you can use this, it stays on the wall. But guys, there's things like that that you can do for your business. They cost a lot of money. They do work. It's another being or another opportunity that a customer has to be able to see your company and to be able to think of you when they want those services done. So if you have it in your budget, definitely utilize those things. But if you don't, figure out what platform it is that your customers are using and focus and target that platform. Maybe it's not Facebook. For me, it is. And so figure out which it is and just put your content out there. Maybe you don't have a whole lot of customers or a whole lot of jobs. Don't take and put all of your pictures into one single post. Focus on something like the front yard. Get a really good shot of that before picture and then get a really good shot of that after picture and use that as a post. Focus on the flower bed, one section of that flower bed, and utilize that as a second post, maybe the next day or later that week. And then do the same thing for different angles in different parts of the yard. Sometimes you can even take all of those pictures and make one big post a couple days later after all the other content has been posted. This will allow for you to have several pieces of content on one single project. This is gonna help show other customers how you're staying active and out there working so that you're relevant when they're looking for a company. One thing that's really important when focusing on social media is being consistent. You want to make sure that you're continuously making posts. Not that you post one this week and maybe one at the end of next week and maybe one a few weeks later, but you're keeping that content coming out. So figure out what is manageable for you as a company and then follow that schedule. If it's 3 times a week, then it's 3 times a week, but figure out what it is and then stick to that schedule. These platforms are gonna like the consistency, and once you figure out your pattern, they're gonna push this content out in front of more people. Some things that you can do to your posts are just kind of get consistent with the text and how you're gonna word things and how you're gonna feature, you know, whatever it is, those types of pictures. And then also look at things like maybe putting a watermark of your logo on the bottom corner of the image, or maybe put a certain border out around these. Anything that you can do that's separate from other companies and their post is gonna help you to be recognized. So think about those things that you can add to your pictures and be able to push your content out in front of people and catch their eye. So once you have that figured out, the next thing you're gonna be looking at is posting ads to Marketplace, Swap Shop, and Craigslist. These are three free sites that you can use to be able to push and market your company as long as they allow soliciting. So be sure and read the guidelines and make sure that that page allows it before you get booted off. So they're gonna put the most recent post to the top. This may mean that you have to post more frequently. The thing is with posting more frequently is just to keep all of your ads looking consistent. So be sure that you follow the same border or the same watermark or the same font and description. So that way when they see it, they recognize it and they relate it to your company. Also, probably change your profile pic to something that's gonna catch their eye when they're scrolling through there. So guys, these are just some basic ways that you can be able to market your company this fall without spending any money. If you wanna see a deeper dive into this, or maybe getting into some of the paper documents, door hangers, ways to put the price out in front of your customers, you know, be sure and leave a comment down below. We'll be sure and cover that in another video. The next step that you can do outside of this, guys, is to get you some little flyers made up, even if they're on like some colored construction paper, so that you can give out free estimates, do some clover leafing when you're doing other properties, and then maybe think about putting some yard signs out in the properties that you're servicing. Make sure that you have your trucks logoed up. All of these are gonna help you get those bings and landing customers' attention when they're looking for their next company to hire. For those of you that have been reaching out to me via email, explaining to me about your business and just doing a deeper dive into our documents and our mentorship program, I really do appreciate that. Thank you so much. It's just what fuels us and keeps us going. It's really what sparked tonight's video. We had several people reach out to us wanting to find ways that they could grow and start to be noticed in the industry and to market their company. And we were thinking, how can we do that, but how can we do it on a budget? So we are gonna be jumping a deeper dive into marketing and focusing on branding your company, but that is going to be in another video. So guys, I really want to show my appreciation. In the video we had the other day, it did really well, the 3,000 to 9,000 in revenue and the steps that we took in implementing our lawn maintenance contracts. And we did a hoodie giveaway. So the winner of that hoodie giveaway is Stuart Spicer. And thank you so much. Here it is. It has our logo on the front. And on the back, it has our cross with Isaiah 48. And it says, the grass withers, the flowers fade, but the word of God stands forever. And it's got our information. So this is some swag that we wear out working every day. And I wanna bless you with one of these as well. So please reach out to me, leave a comment down below. Let us know how we can get in contact with you. If any of you guys know him, please reach out to him. I'm gonna be doing some more giveaways. Let me know if you like this. Something that we can do. You wanna know what? Let's do one now. Let's see. All right, I got it. What I wanna know is how many properties you service a week. So if you leave a comment down below letting us know how many properties you service a week, we are going to do another drawing for another hoodie. So guys, we're gonna give out another one of these here in, let's say, a week. Thank you so much for just tuning in, checking out our channel, supporting us. It means so much. Just, I can't wait to either one, get connected with you, meet you, or just help you grow your business. Guys, please like, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video.